While interfacing with officials of the Ministry of Justice and Constitutional Affairs over queries raised by the Auditor General's report for the year 30th June 2021, the Public Accounts Committee of Parliament was shocked to learn that the Ministry of Justice has accumulated huge unpaid court awards after Compesation standing 377 billion Uganda shillings. MPs questioned why their outstanding arrears are not taken a priority. Are not taken a priority by the ministry, yet they accumulate interest on principal amounts, penalties, and damages.
These money, these areas, some of them date back to 10 years ago. And they also attract interest. So I don't know how much effort the ministry puts in to actually ask finance to release funds so that they can pay off.
You know how dangerous that it is, that one is to the economy, and also how it distorts budgeting. But also members need to note that it is not solely the responsibility of this ministry.
Officials attributed the query to insufficient budget provisions. They promised to engage relevant stakeholders to provide a sufficient budget for the committees.
Engaged the relevant stakeholders, including the Presidential Advisory Committee on Budget, the Committee on Legal and Parliamentary Affairs, and the Ministry of Finance, to provide the sufficient funds.
When they don't even also budget. So evidence must be provided that they budgeted for 399 billion, but it was just done.
The problem when I look this way, you think I'm allowing you to talk.
And this thing called domestic arrears has very serious implications on the economy. You do not pay your debtors. As a result, you cripple the economy.
Park was concerned to discover that the Ministry of Justice has no clear criteria used to prioritizing the settlement of court awards.
And Chair, considering that the arrears span to 10, 5 years, it's also possible that whoever is connected or has an offer is the one who could be maybe paid. Those who are not connected or have no godfathers may never be paid.
Chaired by Medet Segona, the committee also grilled the Ministry of Justice and Constitutional Affairs over diverting 18.2 billion shillings meant for COVID-19 emergency interventions, which was diverted and spent on paying domestic arrears.
So you're talking about interventions on COVID-19.
Did you receive any instructions alongside this money?
But I think that time there was a circular word was saying to, was it to rejuvenate the economy? They are going to first pay arrears, any kind of arrears, not specifically related to COVID.
In the same vein, they interfaced with the officials of the Office of the Directorate of Public Prosecution and grilled them on the huge case backlog in the ministry. According to the Auditor General's report, only 253,596 cases have been prosecuted to the conclusion in the last 5 years out of the 582,660 cases registered, which represents a 33% performance.
Because we interfere with you, we the politicians. So while you talk about the case backlog that the Honorable Nandala Mafabi is talking about, it is created by 1, inadequate staffing, 2, poor facilitation and welfare, that people really don't put their brains to work, and 3, unnecessary workload that you put onto yourselves.
The challenges of staff are being stretched arises from so many cases that should have not gone to court. So how we wish you work with the CID and drop some of these small cases.
The committee also questioned the office of the IGG of slapping fresh charges on prisoners who have been released by court.
But prison and charged for, you know, 3 years. Court releases him and says he's innocent. Then immediately you jump onto the same person and say, we have another charge. Oh, you are not there during the arrest. The police has done that a job for you. And you can't stand on your feet to say, no, we will not do it.
Story compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news in Kampala.